got your numbing cream on, so we're going to do your lips today, but we'll just talk a little bit about your Botox. A lot of times, all my younger patients, they don't need as much Botox because it's just a preventative thing. So by just putting a little bit here and here and maybe a little bit in the crow's feet, it can just help prevent you from getting those lines in the future. And if you just stay with your maintenance, you know, 3 times a year or so, then as you age, you'll just age more gracefully. All the areas that we're going to be injecting. And smile while you squint your eyes up. You don't really need any here in the crow's feet. Maybe in the future, but not quite. And then I'm just going to mark where we need our injection. So raise your eyebrows up. Do it again. Good. So you don't have a lot of movement, so again, we don't need a big dose. We're just kind of sprinkling it around. So not very painful. You're just going to feel little teeny pokes. Sometimes you won't feel them at all. So a little poke right here. And most people don't really bleed with Botox. You can. If you're somebody that just has thin blood, but you're not bleeding at all, so you won't get any bruising. And it's really rare to bruise with Botox. Sometimes when you get lip filler, you can get a bruise, but with Botox, it's rare. I always change my needles out pretty frequently so that it's more comfortable for you. Make an angry face again. Okay, relax. So you'll be thinking about coming back in about 3 to 4 months, and we'll just touch this up again. Okay, and that was it. Not bad. And for the rest of the day, just no exercise. Keep your head elevated for about 4 hours. Try not to rub too much because we just want all the Botox to stay exactly where we put it. And then tomorrow you can go back to normal. Awesome.